McCluster has it. Thought about throwing. Cuts it back and takes a big shot. Darian Stewart, the senior, delivered the blow. Came in with a stinger. A shoulder injury. Delivered a stinging shot there.
I just said a play or two ago that if you're going to stop McCluster, you better go attack him, right? Now, if McCluster could throw the ball, it'd been big time. Go get him.
And how about freshman defensive end Devin Taylor staying home, keeping his containment, not biting on the first sweep, but getting ready for the double reverse?
Is he trying to pass the ball there? You think he looks like he's trying to line the laces up? He's 0 for 5 with two picks in his career passing. They tried a little bit of throwing out of the old Wild Rebel last year. Didn't quite do it as well as McFadden does.
He'd have been 0 for 6 if he'd have tried there. The receiver had outrun his arm.
All right, what do you think on 3rd and 12?
That'd get you 5 or 6. Get manageable, right?
Exactly. You don't need the whole thing right now. This is the final drive. This will be your last possession if you're Ole Miss. You need to get some of this yardage back. You still have one timeout left, but give yourself an opportunity to continue moving the chains.
And the raid breaks out in Columbia. Norwood knows if he can make one more big play, the Gamecocks will have the win. 1 of 12 on 3rd down tonight, and they need 12. Sneed chased. Sacked. Matthews got him. Again lost his helmet, but made a big play. 4th and 14.
And Dexter McCluster wasn't even in the game. You know, the best player on their team's not in the game on a critical 3rd down attempt.
And now they'll spend their final timeout to talk about a 4th down call.
Give Ellis Johnson, the play caller on defense for South Carolina, a ton of credit. In some crucial situations tonight on big down and distances, he's been able to dial up some pressures to get after Jevin Snead. Now, we'd expect on this final play something that's been working is when they only rush two or three guys, let those defensive tackles just kind of spy Jevin Snead, force him to move up, and then get after him.
And the reason the two and the three-man rush has worked is it's lulled to sleep Ole Miss's offensive line. They have got to come out if they're the uncovered linemen and help on the outside, because those ends have run right around the corner and they've gotten a Jevin Snead.
So much at stake on this play. Again, Ole Miss ranked as high as they are at number 4 for the first time since 1970. This is the game circled on their schedule, their first big test of the season. Do you bring pressure if you're Ellis Johnson? Do you pressure Snead, or do you sit back?
Again, line up with 4 defensive linemen, let the ends pin their ears back and go, line them up wide and allow those defensive tackles and your Mike linebacker to just spy everything. When the packet collapses, it's like a green dog rush. You just rush on a delay.
Create the umbrella at about 6 or 7 yards. Keep all the receivers in front of you.
Never beaten a top 5 team at home. They're one stop away from doing it. And the Rebels out of a timeout and an extra man on the field. Derek Davis was trotting off late. Now it's going to be tougher. 4th and 19.
You saw a coach about 8 yards onto the field trying to get Derek Davis off.
How does that happen out of a timeout?
Just not into it the entire game.
Before the snap, illegal substitution on the offense. 5 yards from the previous spot, still 4th down.
See Houston Nutt here at the top of the screen. He's about 8 yards on the field trying to get his fullback off. You're right. They talk about personnel groupings during that timeout, who's going on the field. This isn't a CFL.
You know what I'd like in this play here? You know what I'd really like is a hook and lateral. Get the ball in Dexter McCluster's hands somehow, some way.
He's in the slot, Craig. Snead fires downfield. Incomplete. Battling for the ball was Darian Stewart and Shea Hodge. Gamecocks going to upset the number 4 team. There's a flag down, so hold on. Near hash mark in conference.
After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct. Number 40 on the defense, taking his helmet off. The perimeter is 15 yards from the succeeding spot.
They got Eric Norwood after the play. I guess he's entitled to feel good about himself after this effort.
He's had a monster game. He's made big plays. This defense has stepped up when they needed to. What a win for the program. Only the second time in school history they've beaten a top five team.
Had to have it in the SEC race. Had a chance to win at Georgia. It slipped away. They knew they couldn't drop to 0-2 in the conference. And for Ole Miss, they're not going to get that first 3-0 start since 89. They'll drop to 0-1. Got to go to Vanderbilt next week. And then the game that everybody down in Oxford had pointed to for a long time. Crimson Tide coming there.
You know what? Ole Miss will have a fine football season. This is a football team that just hasn't gotten it on track yet. All of the distractions and the things that we talked about earlier. But rest assured, Ole Miss is a good football team, and Jevon Snead will come on.
Let me ask you this question. South Carolina was one play away from beating a ranked Georgia team on the road. How good is South Carolina?
I think they're a top 15 football team easily.
They also came close to losing to NC State, the game that you guys saw.
They won. But they won.
They did.
While you were on the couch watching U.S. Open, they did win.
They won and they lost to Georgia.
They did.
A Wrangler five-star player of the game, Steven Garcia. It wasn't always pretty. Doesn't complete 50%. 220 yards and a touchdown, and they just bring those automatic goalposts down. and the players are rushing the student section as Aaron Andrews fighting to get near Steve Spurrier on the field. Clock ticking down to 5 seconds. Frustrating night for Jevon Snead and a good one for Steve Spurrier. Aaron?
Coach, I know you've been a part of some pretty big wins in your career, but this is the first time you've beaten a top five team at home. What does that mean?
We beat Kentucky here a couple years ago, but our defense was really sensational. Our offense, we couldn't make a first down fourth quarter.
That defense, what was key in getting pressure on Jevon Snead all night?
All of our players played their assignments very well tonight on defense, and really proud of our entire team. It's a good win for South Carolina. Hopefully we get a little offense going, but it's a great win for all of our fans and university.
All right, Coach, thanks. Chris?
You knew he was going to be happy with the win because the offense wasn't good. The Gamecocks have righted the ship. South Carolina State and Kentucky, the next two games that got them here at home.
Don't blow what you did tonight.
Savor that fact, whether Ole Miss really was a top five team in reality. That's for you to decide. They will certainly be dropping out of the top 10 after this loss. 16-10 South Carolina Sports Center coming up next. John Anderson and Scott Van Pelt, ESPN News. We have post-game extra. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Craig, Jesse, and Aaron, our entire team in Columbia. I'm Chris Fowler. So long for now. The Rebels go down. Gamecocks win at 16-10.